Penguin Random House Audio presents Better Breastfeeding, A Doctor's Guide to Nursing Without Pain and Frustration. This is the author, Linda Dahl, MD. Introduction: The Wild West of the Breastfeeding World. Most of the 4 million moms who give birth each year in the United States and 130 million worldwide try to breastfeed. Sometimes it happens easily, and when it does, we call it natural. But nature is messy. It's full of accidents and near misses, which is where modern medicine steps in. Take childbirth as an example. It is the second leading cause of death in women of childbearing age worldwide, and 10th in the United States. If it weren't for medical interventions, such as C-sections, that number would be a lot higher. Pregnancy is no different. Some women spend years and countless dollars trying to get pregnant. Natural doesn't necessarily mean automatic. As with every other part of the human experience, we are grateful we aren't wholly at the mercy of nature. But for some reason, when it comes to breastfeeding, we are made to believe that nature will make it work every time. The truth is, the majority of moms need help breastfeeding, and a good portion of those moms fail. Even worse, they are coached, coddled, pushed, and convinced to breastfeed for all the positive outcomes, while the negative impact of trying and failing is entirely ignored. Failed breastfeeding is one of the most terrible things that can happen to a new mom. Not only does it increase her chance of developing postpartum depression, but it can also make it harder for her to bond with her baby. This isn't just unfortunate, it's cruel. I should know because it happened to me. I got pregnant at the end of my ear, nose, and throat residency. Although the timing wasn't ideal, my decision to breastfeed was a no-brainer. I knew it was best for my baby, and I prayed it would create a bond between us that would outlast my mere 6 weeks of leave. I assumed I would have struggles, like finding a decent place to pump in the hospital and figuring out how to pad my chest so I wouldn't leak during surgical cases. Little did I know, my concerns were focused in entirely the wrong direction. When my daughter was born, we were off to a good start. She latched on right away and was constantly attached to my full breasts. Although my nipples were sore, she seemed happy enough. By day two, however, the soreness turned into a gnawing pain, which I was assured was all part of their toughening up process. It hurts even though it's not supposed to hurt, one of the labor and delivery nurses told me. So I soldiered on, pulling out appropriate idioms to bolster my fading enthusiasm. No pain, no gain for the lumpy plugged ducts that littered my breasts. If it were easy, anybody could do it, for those endless days turned to nights of nursing every other hour for an hour. Nothing good comes easy, for pumping and only getting half an ounce of milk from both breasts. After 2 weeks, I checked in with my daughter's pediatrician to make sure what I was going through was normal. I didn't want to complain. I was told that every woman can breastfeed, and I didn't want to be one of those selfish moms who chose not to. It just seemed a little extreme. She's lost some weight, the pediatrician said, but that's normal in the first few weeks. Keep feeding her and give her some bottles of formula just to be safe. Formula? Formula was for quitters. I wasn't a quitter. I just needed more specialized help. So off to a breastfeeding support group I went. What at first seemed like a meeting of like minds quickly turned into worried competition. The other moms weren't nursing as often, and when they latched on their much fatter babies, I didn't see any bleeding nipples. Then came the weigh-in. After nursing for a mere 20 minutes, each baby had taken down a good 2 to 3 ounces. Mine had taken a fraction of an ounce. With a furrowed brow, the lactation consultant handed me the number of a private lactation consultant. She assured me that every woman can nurse, so I should keep trying. But I should also consider supplementing with a liquid enema to be safe. The private consultant wasn't much help either. After spending a small fortune, I left with no answers. She was unable to get my daughter to latch on any better than I could, and as it turned out, there was no sense in trying. After only 4 weeks, my supply had dwindled to nothing. Not even the hospital-grade pump she insisted I rent from her helped. For the next 4 months, even though I attached myself to it religiously, my supply stayed consistently low, at only 2 ounces for the whole day. When I finally gave up, I looked back, wondering where I went wrong. I had asked for help and followed the advice I was given. They were professionals, right? Even though I was training to be a surgeon, I was still a new mom who didn't know what I was doing. The failure had obviously been my fault, because every woman can breastfeed. I wish I could say my story is only my story, but unfortunately, it is the story of countless women. Every year, nearly 4 million babies are born in the United States. And although, according to the 2018 CDC breastfeeding report card, 83.2% of those moms try to breastfeed, less than half, 46.9%, are successfully nursing at 3 months. While the discussion over why these rates are so low could go on for days, numbers and rates don't speak to individual experiences. When it's 3 a.m. and you're a new mom with bleeding nipples and an insatiable baby, individual experiences are all that matter. The truth is that 20 to 25% of moms can't make breastfeeding work no matter how hard they try. And in today's breastfeeding-friendly environment, the pressure for moms to nurse is even more intense. But even as support for breastfeeding grows, the advice given by healthcare practitioners is confusing and often downright wrong. Even though more healthcare practitioners than ever support the idea of breastfeeding, the medical understanding of its pitfalls and failures is stuck in the dark ages. Doctors have no training on breastfeeding, but that doesn't stop them from doling out opinions disguised as facts. And lactation consultants, who often have little to no medical background, have become the experts. In desperation, moms turn to the internet and online chat groups, ending up even more confused and frustrated. If things work out, great. Everyone takes credit. If not, moms are led down an expensive road of pain and suffering, only to wind up at its inevitable dead end. The tragedy is that when they finally give up, they are the ones getting blamed for failure. There are a lot of books about breastfeeding, so how is this one different? First, nearly all other books come from the outdated, patronizing perspective that every woman can breastfeed if she only tries hard enough. Instead of differentiating between normal and abnormal, they consider all breastfeeding experiences part of a continuum of normal. These books focus on avoiding and overcoming common breastfeeding difficulties without explaining why they happen in the first place. Even with new editions, most are way behind the times. They are part of an outdated paradigm. None discuss tongue tie or the myriad oral restrictions that are currently enjoying an overdiagnostic moment. There is no consensus on what these diagnoses actually mean. None of these books are written by a physician who understands the anatomic and physiologic pitfalls of failed breastfeeding. None of these authors will even admit that some moms won't be able to breastfeed no matter what. Breastfeeding isn't always a choice. For many, it isn't even possible. There's a very fine line between supporting breastfeeding and shaming women who don't or can't. For countless moms, breastfeeding has become a bigger stress than pregnancy and childbirth. Breast may be best, but not if your baby can't get your milk out. How are you supposed to nurse through agonizing pain? Where's your blissful surge of oxytocin? Isn't the whole point of breastfeeding to make it easier to bond with your baby? No one talks about how painful breastfeeding can actually hurt your ability to bond. And if you bring it up, you are called selfish and subjected to the shame police, just like I was. When I went into practice, I spent years trying to figure out what had happened to me. Moms and babies often came to the pediatric practice I had been hired into, but instead of ignoring their plight, I listened. I listened as a mother first and a doctor second. Their stories were so similar to mine, I knew there had to be an underlying explanation. What followed was a deep dive into the intricate, complicated process of breastfeeding. I learned about tongue tie and the standard treatment, which involved cauterizing, or burning, the baby's mouth to stop the bleeding. I adapted the procedure, performing it more precisely, and getting the babies to nurse immediately afterward, avoiding cautery. The results were extraordinary. Babies were able to latch right away. Mom's woes were cured instantly. I was on to something. My drive to end suffering carried me beyond simple tongue tie and into the uncharted territory of the mechanics of gape and latch. I learned about how the many variables and moving parts have to work both independently and synchronously for breastfeeding to succeed. I studied with practitioners from different perspectives, like Chinese medicine and osteopathy. I learned from seasoned lactation consultants. I studied my patients, recorded my findings, and after many years, solved an age-old problem. I figured out how breastfeeding works, why it fails, how to fix it, and how to know when it won't work, no matter what you try. I developed a new paradigm of breastfeeding. Word spread about my work, and struggling moms and babies came from near and far because no one else could help them. Over nearly two decades, I've treated more than 22,000 nursing pairs in New York City and the surrounding areas. I am known as the guru of breastfeeding. Some call me a baby whisperer.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.